Hey there, how you doing, Kees? My name is Robert. In this mandolin lesson we're going to play a classic rock song that's called White Room from the British rock formation The Cream. And here's Joost, our movie star. Say hello to your fans, Joost. Joost has fans all over the world. Before we start with the lesson, I want to say that we do have a website, Robert Rocks the Mandolin. There you can find playing charts, chords, written out solos, anything you need to help you with the songs you're playing during this video lessons. My wife Cecilia creates all files on printable PDFs, so visit our website. Let's look at the song. An intro, verse, bridge, break, verse, bridge, break, and a solo part, the final solo. So let's start with the intro. Play it out for you first and then explain it. There we go. That's the intro. Sounds nice, doesn't it? How are we going to play that? Starting with the first line, G minor chord, 4 plus 1 count. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. F chord, same thing. 4 plus 1 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. D minor chord, same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. C chord, 4 plus 1 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Line number 2. Play it almost in the same way. G minor chord again, 4 plus 1 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. F chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. D minor chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. C chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And now we're getting an A minor 7, and that's just one downstep. That's the step up to the first verse. Sounds nice, doesn't it? Hogan. We're entering verse number 1. Play it out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's verse number 1. Sounds nice, doesn't it? So we're gonna play that. We're starting with the first line. D suspended 2 chord. And we're gonna pick that in this way. The open D string, the bass. And then one down string on the whole D suspended 2 chord. Second chord. D suspended 2 also, but now with a C bass. So put the middle finger on the 5th position of the top string. And we're gonna pick that twice. And then down some on the suspended 2 chord without touching the high E string, otherwise it's dominating during the whole line and that's irritating. Next chord, D suspended 2 chord also, but now with a B bass, so index finger on the 4th position of the top string, pick it twice and then and this way. So from the beginning. We're getting a kind of a connection riff, 2 chords, that's B flat chord, 1 downstrum, C chord, 1 downstrum, and then we're getting the second part of the first line, and that's played in the same way as the first line, first part of the first line. So D suspended 2 D bass, D suspended 2 C bass, D suspended 2 B bass, and then B flat chord, 1 downstrum, C chord, 1 downstrum. Second line of the first verse played in exactly the same way as the first line. There we go. Line number 3 played in the same way. There we go. Starting with the D bass. Line number 4, same way, here we go. That's the first verse. We're entering the bridge. Play it out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's the bridge part. Sounds nice. How are we gonna play that? We're starting with the first line. C chord, four counts. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. G chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. B flat chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. A chord, two counts. 1, 2. A7, one time count. And back to A, one count. So one more time. The first line of the bridge for you, here we go, starting with the C chord. Second line of the bridge, C chord again, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. G chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. B flat chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. C chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. D chord, two counts this time. 1, 2. And now we're getting a riff, open A string. And now hammer on the index finger, second position of the A string, this way. And now we're getting the ring finger on A5, pick it twice. Middle finger A3. And back to A5. So there's the whole riff. And now we're doing the drum riff from Ginger Baker also. So pick the open D string, then ring finger G5, and next finger G2, and open D string. And this way, that's the drum riff from Ginger Baker. It sounds if the man tuned his drums in tones. So, one more time, the second line of the bridge for you in a slow tempo. Starting with the C chord, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the bridge. We're entering verse number 2. And verse number 2 has the same construction as the first verse. So, you can play it in this way. Or you can play it kind of pickwise. I've seen it during live versions on YouTube from Eric Clapton. So that sounds then in this way. So with the choice is the choice is yours. We want to play strumwise. Or you want to play it pickwise. So that's the whole second verse. We entering the bridge part again. Small difference in it. So play it out for you, the bridge. And then explain it. There we go. That's the bridge part. We're gonna play that. First line is played in the same way as the earlier bridge we played, starting with the C chord, four counts. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. G chord. 1, 2, 3, 4. B flat, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. A chord, two counts. Here we go. A7. And back to A. Second line of the bridge. And there's a small difference in it. So here we go. C chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. G chord, 1, 2, 3, 4. B flat chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. C chord, four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. D chord, four counts this time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Without the riffs. We're entering the break again. And the break is played in exactly the same way as the intro played. So here we go. Starting with the G minor chord. 4+1 count. Here we go. Thank you. That's a break, and we entering verse number 3. And verse number 3 has the same construction as verse 1 and 2. It's this way. So, and you can play it pickwise if you want also, why not? So the choice is yours, if, what you prefer, the strum-wise thing or pick-wise. It always, both sounds very nice in the song. So that's verse number 3. We're entering the bridge again, and the bridge is played in the same way as the last bridge we played. So but at the end, the D chord 4 counts without any riffs. So here we go. The bridge, C chord. 1, 2, 3. Entering the break again. Here we go, starting in, of played in the same way as the intro, starting with G minor. That's a break, and now we're entering the final solo part, and the solo part has the same construction as the verses. And there's a solo part. And it sounds better, I think, if you play this chord strum-wise during the solo. No, and the final chord is just one down strum on the D suspended 2 chord. That's White Room from the British rock formation Cream. Explained! Very nice song to play on the mandolin. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I did. I hope to see you next time. Visit our website, Robert Rocks the Mandolin. Take care. Ciao, tschüss, arrivederci, buenas noches, Deutsch, Vidania, how do, goodbye, and ref from Joost.